Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to perform filtering in the .NET MAUI DataGrid control. I'll show you how to filter the records in the view, filter based on conditions, filter items in a particular column, and clear applied filters. I'm using the example application that was pre-configured with the necessary namespace and added MAUI DataGrid control with data. You can watch the Getting Started video I've shared in the YouTube card. You can also download the Getting Started example from the link provided in the description. Now, I run the application on an Android emulator. As you can see, the data grid displays all the data in a clear and concise manner. Let's see how to filter records simply by using a button. First, add a button to filter records with a clicked event. To enhance the button's visibility, I label it as filter and adjust its margin to 3. Next, go to the main page XAML CS file. Create a new method called filter records. Here, use a predicate to filter the data. For example, if I want to filter rows containing Germany, first, create a new variable to get the order info details from the method's parameter. Then check whether the order info is not equal to null, and the country is Germany. If it is, returns true. Otherwise, returns false. Next, within the button clicked event handler, add the data grid view filter. And set its value to filter records. Then, to refresh filtered records, call the view's refresh filter method. Save these changes and run the application. Once the data grid is loaded, click on the filter button. You can see that the data grid shows only the rows containing the country Germany. Next, let's see how to filter records based on condition. The most used conditions are equal, does not equal, and contains. Before starting, remove the button in the main page XAML. After that, add the picker control to display the conditions in the UI and set its name to conditions. And add margin and width request properties to customize it. Then, define the items property. And add appropriate strings to that picker. To indicate the selected condition, define the selected item property. And set it to equal. To customize the better UI, load this picker inside a stack layout. Then, add a label to indicate the filter options. Next, add a search bar to search for items. Set its name to filter text. And adding placeholder property to display the short description on the UI. Then, define the search button pressed event to invoke filtering records. Now, go to the main page XAML CS file and create a new method called onFilterChanged. Inside this method, check whether the data grid view is not null. If it is, add the view filter code changes. After that, call this onFilterChanged method to filter the records inside the search button pressed event. To get the search bar text value, let me create a string variable named filter text and assign empty value to it. To set value for filter text, go to the main page XAML and define the text changed event in the search bar. Then, navigate to this event handler method and get the filter text value when it's changed. Finally, update the filter records method based on conditions. In this method, remove the existing code changes. First, check the order info and the condition picker's selected item are not null. After that, check whether the condition picker's selected item is contains. If it is, create a new variable named filter text and set its value to the lowercase of filter text. Also, check whether any property's value of order info contains the filter text. If it does, it returns true. Otherwise, it returns false. Next, check whether the condition picker's selected item is equal. If it is, check whether the filter text is equal to any property's value of the order info. If it is, it returns true. Otherwise, it returns false. Finally, check whether the filter text is not equal to any property's value of the order info. If it is, it returns true. Otherwise, false. Okay, the changes are done. Let me run the application. You can see the conditions picker and search bar are shown above the data grid. Type 1010 in the search bar and click the search button. You can see the filtered records on the data grid. Next, type London and click the search button. You can see the result. Now, change the condition to contains. Type 101 and click the search button. You can see the data grid shows the rows that contain 101. Type LON and click the search button. You can see the rows that contain LON. Next, let's see how to filter records in a specific column. First, go to the main page XAML. Create a new picker and set its name to columns and add margin and width request properties to customize it. Then, define the items property and add appropriate strings to that picker. To display the selected item in the UI, let me add the selected items property with the value order ID. Next, go to the XAML CS file to modify the filter records method based on conditions for all or a particular column. Check whether the column picker's selected item is not null. After that, check whether the column's selected item is all columns. If it is, move the existing condition picker's code changes to inside this condition. Otherwise, add the filter code changes to the column. Here, first, get the property value of the record from the column picker's selected item. Then get the exact value of the record. After that, check whether the condition picker's selected item is not null. If it is, add filter code changed for all the conditions like contains, equals, and does not equal. Save these changes and run the application. You can see the additional picker shown for the columns condition. Now, type 1005 and click the search button. You can see the filtered records in the order ID column. In case, I change the condition to does not equal. You can see the row that contains 1005 in the order ID column is not visible. Change the condition to contains. And column to ship city. Then, type LON and click the search button. The data grid now shows only the rows that contain LON in the ship city column. Now, change the column to all columns. And click the search button. You can see the rows that contain LON in any column. Finally, I will show you how to clear filtered records. First, go to the main page XAML. And add a new button with a clicked event. And add margin and text properties to customize it. After that, navigate to the button clicked event. Here, set the data grid view filter to null. Then, call the view refresh filter method. Once that's loaded, search for 1003 in this list. You can see the filtered item in the order ID column. Now, click the clear button. Notice here, the filtered records are cleared, and the data grid shows all the records. In this video, I have shown you how to filter records in the data grid view and based on conditions for all or a particular column. You also saw how to clear filtered records. If you want to see a working example, you can download it from the GitHub link provided in the video's description. I have also included a link in the description where you can check whether you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI control suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.